If you would have told me that week four in the NFL, the Philadelphia Eagles will be getting their first win, already had a tie, and somehow on top of the NFC East, I would look at you like, huh? But guess what? That's exactly what happened. What is going on, everybody? For those who don't know, I go by Philly Mike, and this is the Philly Talk Podcast. If you are new to the channel and love talking Philly sports every single day, I'm talking NFC East first place talk, hit that subscribe button and make sure you turn on post notifications so you know when I go live or drop some content. On that note, if you watched last night's game and said, you know what? Put some respect on the Eagles. We're in first place and we're not done yet. Smash that like button. With all that being said, let's jump into Victory Monday and First Place Monday. So as we all know, last night the Philadelphia Eagles handled business going into San Fran as an 8.5-point underdog. The Philadelphia Eagles win 25-20 and are on top of the division, first place of the NFC East with a 1-2-1 record. But I do want to say this. The Eagles came out and showed me heart. They didn't give up. They had a slew of injuries. I'm talking Travis Fulgham, Deontay Burnett, John Hightower, and Greg Ward Jr. were our only active receivers. A fifth round draft pick and a bunch of practice squad receivers. But they got the job done. In clutch situations, Greg Ward Jr., John Hightower, and Travis Fulgham stepped up along with the offensive line play who lost Lane Johnson. He was in and out and in and out. You're talking about Jason Kelce being the only guy who was a starter on the line. Jordan Mailata, Nate Herbig, Matt Pryor, Jack Driscoll. These guys did a great job against the Niners D-line who were injured. And like I said, the Niners had a slew of injuries as well. However, Vegas still had these guys at 8.5-point favorites. So they thought they were going to run through the Philadelphia Eagles. And Nick Mullins came out of his shell and he showed his true colors. This guy threw for over 300 yards against the Giants. And I was impressed as well. And I said Kyle Shanahan and his system can use any quarterback. But the Philadelphia Eagles defense came out and said no. Real quick, shout out to my guy Big Play Slay, who continues to thrive in this system, playing lockdown defense, but more importantly is a trooper. Last week he gets his arm bent back in a way that I thought he was going to be out for a while, and he stayed in the game. This game, the guy used the crown of his helmet right into his knee. I thought that was going to be bad. Stayed in the game. He's battling, he's tested, and he's ready to come out and run this Eagles defense as the leader in the secondary. Shout out to Jalen Mills for making the switch to DB. I saw some good things from Kevon Wallace trying his best to stop the best tight end in the game, who had his way with 15 catches. But again, the Eagles defense with three turnovers, a Ronnie McLeod pick, a Alex Singleton pick six, and a big sack fumble from our guy Crevion LeBlanc. We couldn't handle George Kittle, but not many teams could. But shout out to the defense. And let me get some respect to my guy Carson Wentz. For those who were in the live stream with me and even the post game, my voice is kind of messed up because of all the screaming. And more importantly, the sipping and the screaming. And I was a little bit slurry in the post game, but shout out to you guys for sticking with me. I'm going to continue to do post game live streams, and I also will continue the play-by-play, but I won't be drinking like that again. Took a V-day, knew I wasn't going to have to go to work, and I used it to my advantage, and in good faith of the Philadelphia Eagles getting a W, a much needed W. Some of the negativity around this locker room and morale will go away just from this win. And let me talk Carson Wentz real quick. This guy was battle tested. He definitely counted on his young talent, and the young talent came through. We kind of see a resemblance of last year where he had Greg Ward Jr., Rob Davis, Deontay Burnett, Josh Perkins, Boston Scott. These young guys really looked up to Carson Wentz, and he put them in spots to win and succeed. Even J.J. Arcega-Whiteside down the stretch was good. We haven't seen him, but my guy, Travis Fulgham, Deontay Burnett, John Hightower, Greg Ward Jr. continuing to trust Carson Wentz, and Carson Wentz gets him the ball in clutch times. And the one thing I am super happy to see back in Carson Wentz's arsenal is the scrambling. I'm not even talking about for the touchdown or for the first down or on that third and nine. I'm talking about the mobility in the backfield to just elude sacks. Get out there. He's making better decisions to throw the ball away. But my goodness, on that third and nine, when he was scrambling for his life, he runs for 11 yards and a first down. That was big time. The Philadelphia Eagles offense, although it had a lot of times where the drives were killed, whether it was the tip interception, whether it was the Jason Kelce throw the ball 20 yards back, whether it was third and one and Jordan Mailata get a key false start, we kept getting setbacks. We had to inch down the field, nothing over the top until the 42-yard touchdown to Travis Fulgham, but we kept it simple and we kept pushing. We never gave up, and on them last two drives, the field goal drive and the touchdown drive, there were key third downs that the offense was able to overcome, and a big fourth and four that Carson Wentz threw the ball with conviction to John Hightower. Like I said, this was a beat up Niners team, but the Vegas line still was at 8.5. And if you watched the pregame on TV, everybody was picking the Niners and everybody was trying to say Nick Mullins is not that bad. Well, he got benched because of the Eagles defense, and the Eagles came out at 8.5 point underdogs and got the W. The Ski Masters were on. Jalen Mills was right. We got the turnovers we needed. We won their turnover battle. Carson Wentz protected the ball except for that tip interception, which really can't go on him because it was tipped. Maybe you can say he should have never thrown it, but it doesn't matter. Carson Wentz stayed in there, stayed tough, grinded it out, used his body as best as he can, and got us the W with, again, who at wide receiver? Greg Ward Jr., John Hightower, and Travis Fulgham. We're talking about two practice squads and a fifth-round receiver. Shout out to all the guys who had that next man up mentality. I'm talking all the receivers. I'm talking Richard Rodgers. I'm talking the offensive line. They got it done. I love it. Doug Peterson was back to being Dougie P, fearless. He used a lot of bootlegs. He used a lot of play action. He moved Carson Wentz like we've been screaming all year long. And the offense still had some stepping stones they got to get through, but the offense looked a lot better. Shout out to the Eagles. Victory Monday, Reaction Monday, first place in the NFC East Monday, and I'm loving it all. And don't let nobody tell you, well, you should have beat the Niners. 8.5 point underdogs say different, and guess what? They can use the excuse, well, we don't want to win the division because it's the NFC East. I mean, the NFC Least. Well, I don't care. I have one goal in mind, to be better than the Cowboys, the Giants, and the Washington football team. And then from there, we talk about playoffs. Let's go, Eagle Nation. Big win this week. The morale's going to be up. We have a huge game against Pittsburgh, but I loved what I see. Crevion LeBlanc, the defense, the sacks from Brandon Graham, Fletcher Cox, Josh Sweat, Jannard Avery was active. I just thought it was a 100% full team effort, and they put the underdog mentality back on, the underdog match, saying next man up. I don't care if we're 8.5 point underdogs. We are going to do whatever it takes to get a W. It wasn't a pretty game, but at the end of the day, the results were pretty. A W, something we haven't got in 2020, but we will build off this going into Pittsburgh. We're going to have a lot of stuff this week when it comes to pre-games for the Pittsburgh thing. Looking to collab with some Eagle content creators because, look, we back in the winning column, and it feels good. Let me know all your thoughts in the comments about that defense performance, the offense performance. Let me know your thoughts because I loved it. Like I said, a total team effort from the coaching staff to the defense to the offense to the special teams. Great win. Let's go. Leave your thoughts in the comment section, how you felt about every single thing from the defense, offense, Carson, Doug. Let me know these Victory Monday thoughts. Until next time, you guys know what time it is. We out.